We have another knife for you. And today we're talking about a Maxpedition fixed blade. This is one of their newer knives, which may not last very long because of some drama. What? Yeah, that's right, some more drama. We'll talk about it a little bit in this video, but I want to focus mainly on the knife, my experiences with it, what I think about it, and so forth. But we will, of course, talk a little bit about the drama, because some of you guys might be familiar with it. If you're very much in the knife community and you're on the forums 24/7, you know, completely just a knife nut, you probably know about this. But for just the average knife guy or gal, you probably don't know about this. So I'm going to talk about it briefly. This new line of fixed blades from Maxpedition is awesome. It's really, really great. There's only one thing I don't like about this knife, which we'll, of course, talk about in this review. One vast improvement I think it could be made upon it. But basically, these knives mimic Mad Dog knives. Okay, if you're not familiar with the company, Mad Dog knives are fixed blades. I mean, it's the same design. So there's a lot of people who are all like, oh my God, I can't believe that they're copying and blah, blah, blah. You know, if you want to read about the drama, you can, of course, do your own research and read all the threads. There's a couple on Blade Forums and a couple of other gun-related forums, believe it or not, because obviously a lot of gun guys are into their gear, love Maxpedition, so that they started talking about this as well. But if you dive deeper into it, you'll find that the owner of both companies, they know each other. They're great friends. In fact, from what I read, could be rumor, but they're close enough friends where they're, you know, going to each other's weddings and stuff, you know? So at the end of the day, when I review knives, I use the knives and I give you my honest opinion of how I feel they perform, what I think about them, the price, you know, what are you getting for your money, good things, bad things, you know, pros and cons, and just, you know, my experiences and facts. I don't like talking too much about the drama. Now, I think we can all agree that if you have a counterfeit knife, so basically you have a product that someone created, you know, and then someone rips it off, they put the fake logos, that whole thing, we're all against that. That's fine. But in the knife community, there's some kind of a line where copies are accepted by some and frowned upon by others. And I'm not here to give you, you know, my, you know, advice on whether you should be buying stuff like this or not, nor am I here to promote or to, you know, talk bad about stuff like that. I'm going to tell you all about this knife and using this knife, okay? I have no experience with Mad Dog knives. What I will tell you is that if you look them up, you'll find they start about $1,000, okay? And they go all the way up to about $2,000. This knife from Mad Dog Knives is about $2,000, okay? And I'm going to make the very safe assumption that most people watching this don't have that money to spend on a fixed blade. This knife is about $110, $120 on Amazon, okay? Or eBay, or, you know, around the same price anyway, around the dealers. You know, the only huge difference between them is that this is in D2 and the Mad Dog knives are in O1. Okay? And there are extremely slight differences here and there, but overall it's the same feel of knife. So you're talking about a knife that's 1/20th of the cost. It is extremely hard not to want to at least try it out before you would fork over the money for, you know, the other one. There's a lot of moral issues here, and like I said, there's a fence. Some people are on this side, some people are over here on this side. I'm not here to talk about that. I'm here to talk about the knife and what I think of it. But what I will say is that I've talked with the owner of Maxpedition before, and this line may not stick around. If you're interested in these, I would get these as soon as possible because I do not foresee these lasting very long. This is a very good friend of his, and he does, of course, doesn't want to offend him. And, you know, he may just cut this line. There's been talk about just getting rid of it completely, making some other knives, and so forth. So if you're interested in this stuff, don't hesitate, because once this is gone, it will be gone. This is one of those things that's happened many times in the knife industry in the past. Something comes out, people complain about it, there's drama around it, boom, no longer made. All right, so don't miss out on the boat if you're interested. So anyway, now that that's all out of the way, let's just talk knives. All right, that's what I'm most comfortable with. I don't really like getting into the drama too much, but I thought it was necessary to talk about it a little bit just to get it out there, because there will be people who mention it anyway. So I figured I'd clear the air on that before, you know, before people start talking about it in the comments. The true story of what's going on is between Maxpedition and Mad Dog Knives. And the one thing I will say about copies, not counterfeits, because we can all, like I said, agree, counterfeits suck, and it's absolutely ridiculous that people counterfeit knives and try to trick people into buying products that, you know, that aren't what they're represented as. But copies are so prevalent in the knife industry, it's ridiculous. You know, everything's a copy of something else. And when something comes out that's, you know, exciting or new design, whatever, there's people copying it. Not counterfeiting it, but copying it because it's popular. Now, when you take something that's $2,000 and you make it affordable at $100, the basically the same design should be, you know, I don't know if you should be faulted for that. But I will say this, there are laws in place in the United States as well as some other countries, copyright laws, and if there's any company that feels like there is an injustice, they should take legal ramifications to fix that. And if they don't have a legal way to stop that, then I don't happen to foresee there's anything wrong with what's going on. So you may agree, you may disagree, it is what it is. But anyway, let's just talk about knives now. So here's the box, okay? I do like their new packaging. It was a nice little presentation. There's a cutout here. It's a fairly fat belt loop on here. So it nestled in nicely. So when you're open, it's a nice little presentation if you're giving it as a gift or whatever. The paperwork was shoved in here, but we don't care about the paperwork. We care about the knives. So let's get this box out of the way. Take the knife out of the sheath and talk about it a little bit. First off, the sheath. I do like the sheath design quite a bit. You can see a nice big opening in the top for the drainage. It's an interesting, you know, like double open-ended design here. Okay, as we slide it in, you can see obviously it spreads apart and then it's molded so it snaps in place. It's very audible snap. There's no wiggle really, just a tiny bit if you really, you know, wiggle it around hard. But when it's on you, it's not making any kind of noise. It's very secure. It's almost a little too tight for my liking. I mean, it's not coming out when you're moving about, climbing, whatever. But when you do want to get it out, you do need a little bit more effort on that. It's a very, very tight snap on here. I do like this kind of design overall. There's no thumb piece here. I've been so used to in the last probably, I don't know, the last year or so, most new knives have, you know, that kind of thumb ramp on the sheath so you can kind of help assist that knife out. This doesn't have it. It's not necessarily a design flaw. It's just I'm so used to the, in my opinion, advanced, you know, sheath style that a lot of YouTubers kind of started, and you know, a lot of custom makers and stuff started putting those on the sheaths, and we kind of expect that to be on every sheath now. So although it's not a huge deal, I would like that. Of course, it would help assist get that knife out of the sheath, but it's a good fit, just a little bit tight for my liking. Also the belt loop, it works great, however it's a little bit wider than I personally like. Now I understand why it's wider. Obviously if you have a duty belt, or if you have you know, a thicker style belt, whether it's, you know, leather or whatever, it's going to be easier to fish through. It's just when this was on my belt, it did wiggle around a little bit just because there's so much depth to it. Not just, you know, width-wise this way, it will accommodate larger belts, but, you know, this width is what I'm talking about. This height, I should maybe say, you know, I got a little bit of wiggle around. Not a big deal, but of course worth mentioning. So that is the sheath. Let's talk about the knife. All right, now this is the large short clip point. So basically it's a large knife, but it's a short clip point. All right, not to get confused with that title. 6.25 inch blade on here, 0.22 inches thick. This is D2. This D2 is double tempered and it has a cryo treatment on it, okay? This also has a very interesting coating. It is hard chrome plated, all right? With that kind of matte gray finish. Excellent coating. Really, really nice coating. Very cool. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, it's the same type of coating that Mad Dog uses on their knives as well. 11 inches overall. The handle is 5.25 inches. It is a molded nylon, you know, plastic or whatever. There is a full hidden tang in here, so the tang does go all the way down. And I believe there's 3 or 4 holes through the stock, or through the blade, so that in the molding process it does continue all the way through the knife. That helps it to grip, you know, against the knife. So overall you have more strength and integrity. If you didn't have the holes or any kind of cutouts in the blade and you didn't overmold, you know, eventually it could, I suppose, slip out. But of course, by drilling some different holes in here, the plastic, it transfers, you know, all the way through and just makes for a stronger handle. I did whack this against a tree a few times in the sheath just to see if it would happen to crack. In the future, I don't know, because I have a feeling these aren't going to be around for long. I don't really want to beat them up, but I might go ahead and do some serious beating on this handle, Because a lot of people have questions, you know, are these over-molded handles, even though they're full tang, how strong are they? What kind of abuse will they take before they crack, break off? I mean, is a chunk going to break off if I drop this on a rock or something? So I might suck it up and do some extreme testing with these. But if you look at the design here, it doesn't look all that exciting, you know? I mean, it's obviously rounded around the edges, which is nice, but just flat front, flat back. But it was surprisingly comfortable. It's very ergonomic. I really like it. Of course, you see there's two finger choils, the pointer, and then of course your middle finger there. It's got a great feel to it. You know, usually I like a little bit more of a palm swell, a little bit more of a sculpted 3D type handle that fills out, you know, the whole hand when you're grabbing it. This is fairly flat, but I was surprised how comfortable this is, even in the reverse grip. Extremely comfortable. There's no jimping on this or any kind of thumb ramps or anything like that. The guard keeps your hand down, so you don't have to worry about your hand riding up too much. I did do some chopping lefty because my finger is still messed up. So it was really, really getting sore using my right hand. So very awkward for me to chop with the left, but you know, I had no problem with this. This blade is flat ground and it has a nice convex edge on it. All right, convex D2, this style package, you know, for $100. I'm game. I think that's great. The one huge downside to me is it's not a deal breaker for me, but it was very disappointing. Okay, and some of you knife guys will already have picked this up by looking at the grind. As you can see, the grind comes all the way down to here. However, we have a finger choil right here. This was very disappointing. Right out of the box, I took a hold of this. Actually, I took it out of the box, went, oh yeah, wow, this is super comfortable. I was surprised how comfortable it was, choked up, and went, what the hell? I don't know why, but the finger choil was put here, and the grind came all the way past it. This is inherently a bad idea because, as you can see, your finger choil ends up being a very thin stock. Now, this is not sharp at all. However, it is too thin to comfortably use. It digs into the finger way too much. One of two things should have happened here. Either the blade should have came down all the way to where the grind is and you should have nixed the finger choil altogether. Just completely get rid of it. Just have the option here. Bring your edge all the way here so we have another inch and a quarter or so of cutting edge. Okay, more capability with this larger knife. Or if you're gonna put a finger choil in there, that's totally fine. But you gotta start that grind at the end of your edge and then maybe bring it up, okay? So this line, this grind should have been right here, coming up. Or, like I said, get rid of this notch and give us more capability, more cutting edge. So that, to me, was a design flaw. This was inherently a bad idea. And it was just uncomfortable because it's too small. If you're doing some light cutting, I mean, I did a little bit of whittling with a stick, whatever, it's fine. But, you know, in testing over and over, it started getting really sore. And I knew it was gonna happen. It wasn't a surprise to me. It's just too damn thin right there. And that's a bummer because other than that, this knife is awesome. It is a really, really nice knife, especially for the price range. Like I said, a nice D2 fixed blade, you know, convex edged from the factory, came razor sharp. Beautiful point on this, being a clip point. I mean, comfortable handle. The handle it doesn't have any grip. It is very smooth plastic, okay? So if you're barehanded, you're doing a lot of work. I felt it slip a little bit. It wasn't gonna fall out of my hands or anything. There is an oversized lanyard hole on here. You might wanna take advantage of that. The finger choils does help facilitate a little bit more grip on it, but you know, in wet conditions, it's gonna get a little slick on you, okay? There is no real grip here. Either gloves, or lanyard, definitely recommended for these. If you're gonna be using it in a wet environment, maybe it's drizzling out, or you know, even if it's humid, it's really hot, your hands are sweating, you will find that it's gonna slip a little bit for you. At least with some of the harder use. So, awesome knife overall. The finger choil, disappointment. The handles, I mean, they are very comfortable. I don't really care about it not having as much grip. For me, I wouldn't use the lanyard. I would just throw on some gloves when I'm using this. If I know it's going to be a little bit damp out or wet, or if it's summer and I'm sweating, I'll throw on gloves and then I'll be totally fine. My fingers will lock in those choils. This was really the biggest bummer in this knife for me. So drama aside, it is completely worth it in my opinion. It's a hell of a knife for the money. I'd get them while you can. I'm making a knife prediction. I don't think that these are going to be around too much longer. A lot of these models are already out of stock directly at Maxpedition's website. You know, pick them up while you can. If you like them, get them while you can. You might see the prices go up, you know, once they're discontinued. Regardless, you know, what's going to happen with this in the future, I do like this knife. It's not the best fixed blade out there, but I'm really excited to see Maxpedition diving deeper into the knife scene, and word on the street is 2015 will not disappoint. So, you know, stay tuned for that. Their Ferox was pretty cool. They're discontinuing them. You know, they were like, okay, that was their entry. You know, it was their first attempt at knife making. And, you know, they definitely needed some improvement, but they weren't all that bad for the price. And then the Excelsa completely just, you know, blew me out of the water. What an amazing knife. Still one of my favorite EDC folders, at least for, you know, a frame lock folder. Still love it. Still using it occasionally. The fixed blades, it was a great idea, but, you know, with the drama that's surrounding it, you probably won't see them too much longer. So, anyway, that's all. That's my review on this Maxpedition large short clip point fixed blade. Hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you soon. Take care.